Now we are discussing about how to treat trading losses in a particular tax year. Sometimes it happens that in a business, whether it's a sole trader business or a partnership business or even in a corporation business, it happens that your accounting profit is negative. And sometimes it happens that accounting profit is positive, but when you adjust it for tax purpose, it might convert into a negative profit or loss. For example, assuming we have tax adjusted trading profit before capital allowances, but we have capital allowances. So if we deduct capital allowances, then that profit converted into tax adjusted trading losses. So while when we are in profit, we have to pay tax on profit, but if we have a loss, then in the year of loss, we'll get some relief from tax authority. And in the year of loss, trading income assessment is considered to be zero, nil. That means in this particular year in which we have a loss, we do not have to pay tax. Rather, we will ask tax authority to give us some relief against the loss. Now, we need to know what are the possible method of getting relief. Now, let's moving towards the loss relief. So I'm telling you the possible loss relief methods. Number one, you can get relief of current year loss against the future available trading profit. And that technique is called carry forward current year loss against future trading profit. Now, it's very important to understand that the current year loss can be offset against future trading profit of the same trade. So in this method, there's a restriction that if you want to get relief against carry forward method, then it is to be offset against the same trade future profit. Now, the next relief that is available is called relief against total income. What it means? It means if you have trading loss, then you can offset your trading loss with other source of income. For example, interest income, dividend income, and if any other source of income exists, you can offset against that source of income. That's why it's called relief against total income. And there are two possible options available. You might get relief against your current year total income, and you might get relief against carry back method, that is the last year total income. We will see it again in a detail that what is current year and what is carry back. And we have some special relief method that is called the opening year loss relief method against total income. And this particular method is only available in opening years of business. So it's a special rule that is only available when you have losses in early years of business. And it is generally not available for all businesses. Similarly, another type of special relief is called terminal loss relief. What is terminal loss? Terminal loss is the loss of the last accounting period. That means when the business decided, your business decides to close their business and we have loss in the year of closure, then we can get relief as terminal loss against trading profit. Again, this is only possible in the year of cessation. So it's a special type of relief. So there are three relief. One is the carry forward, other is the current year and the carry back, which are normal. And there are two special relief. This is called opening year relief and closing cessation year cessation. Another type of relief is called incorporation relief, which we will discuss later on, that what is the meaning of incorporation relief. Now, let's move to in detail one by one. So let's move to carry forward relief first. What it means, how we can get relief, and a simple example. So for example, let's talk about the carry forward relief. When we talk about carry forward relief, it means that if my current tax year is 1920 and I have a loss of say suppose 50,000, I can get relief against the next year available trading profit of the same trade. That means you can get relief of the next year, that is the year 20 and 21. In the next year, if you have profit, then you can offset losses of 1920 from the year 2021. But remember, again, let me remind you, trading profit of the same trade. And this type of relief is automatic relief. What it means? It means if you are not asking to tax authority, then it is assumed that the losses of current year will be relieved as carry forward relief. If you want to opt for other methods, you have to inform tax authority that you are intended to get either current year relief or carry back relief. As far as timing is concerned, this method can carry forward relief indefinitely. What it means? It means that if in the year 1920 we have a loss, and subsequently in 2021 we have no profit, and in the next year we have no profit, so there is no limitation as far as timing is concerned. You can get relief even after 5 years, so there is no time limit, right? But as far as the flexibility is concerned, the partial offsetting is not allowed. For example, what it means? It means that we have a year of loss 1920 and we have 10,000 of loss, assuming. And in year 2021, we have a profit available 5,000. Now, we can offset maximum 5,000 of loss, but if someone wants that, the loss is to be that I want to just take relief of 3,000 and the remaining loss relief from 2022 or 2023, that is not possible, because whatever is the next year profit, you have to offset your loss in the maximum possible way. So in this way, we can say that, let me just give you again example, 2019-20. And we have losses of 10,000. And in 2020-2021, we have a profit of, say, suppose 15,000. Now, there is an opportunity to offset complete 10,000 loss. So if someone wants to offset partial loss, then this is not allowable. This is not possible, right? Even you cannot skip the year that you can skip, and you can get loss from the subsequent years. Now, as far as timing of claim is concerned, if you want to take claim, or if tax authority will provide you claim for 2019-20, for the current year, claim must be made by 5th April 2024. That is 4 years from the end of the current tax year. That is the tax year of loss. So the current tax year end at 6th April, this is the current tax year, 6th April 19 to 5th April 20. Now count 4 years. So it's 21, 22, 23, 24. That means 5th April 2024 is the deadline. Till that date, you can get your relief. If you miss that, you will not get any kind of relief. Now let's move to an example. Assuming we have tax adjusted trading profit and losses available. The year ended December 17, loss is 6,000. So this is the year of loss. So year of loss is 17-18. And subsequently, we have profit in the next year, 2000, not sufficient enough to offset loss. And in the subsequent year, we have profit of 10,000. Calculate assessable trading profit for each tax year 17-18, 18-19, 19-20, assuming what method we are using, the carry forward method we are planning, or we are trying to get the carry forward relief method. Now, I'll use a pro forma, and this is the best way to use a pro forma to solve this kind of losses question. So let me just pick a pro forma, the year 17-18, the year 18-19, and the year 19-20. First of all, write it down, trading income, tax adjusted trading profit or loss. Just write it down. So in the year 17-18, 6,000 loss. So in the year of loss, just write it down, nil. And in the subsequent year, we have loss, then profit of 2,000 and 10,000. So profit is 2,000, profit is 10,000, right? Now, loss relief. That is carry forward loss relief, or you can say that brought forward loss relief, because carry forward, brought forward, the same terminology. So in 1718, there is no possibility. So we have zero. But in 1819, how much loss? Loss is 6,000. We can offset from 2,000. So it's better to create a working that is called, let me just do that, loss memorandum. It is always advisable to create a working first. So loss memorandum, the working. So we have trading loss. We have trading loss of 6,000, and we have to offset from 1819. How much we can offset from 1819? The maximum possible 2,000. So we offset 2,000, and the remaining loss is 4,000. Now from 1920, we have to offset the remaining loss, because we have enough income in 1920 to get the loss relief, and the remaining trading income is 6,000. And that is net income. You can recall the main pro forma when we calculate income tax computation, that from the trading profit, from the total income, if we get tax loss relief, then the remaining is net income. So in this way, the year of loss was 1718, and we get relief we get relief from 1819, and we get relief from 19 and 20. Hence, the loss has been recovered, or the loss has been satisfied. Now, if someone wants to go for carry forward relief, obviously there are methods, advantages and disadvantages of each loss relief method, and you have to plan by yourself that which method is beneficial, which method creates tax advantage, which method creates some other benefits. So as far as the carry forward method is concerned, the benefit is that you have unrestricted period. Means no one is asking that you can only get relief from the next 2 years, from the next 3 years, of the next 4 years. Unlimited time period is available. You have a sigh of relief that you can get relief from the future available profit. But there is a concern that if business is shut down, then there will be a problem. So the condition is that unless continue to trade, your business must remain in continuity, and you must have future available profit. Somewhat it happens that in the year of loss, that in future there are also some other loss period, and business is in difficulty, and business is not able to get sufficient profit. So what are the problems of using this method? The number one problem, it may take long time to get loss relief, because if the loss year is 1920, you might not able to get relief until 25, 26, 27, 28. You have to wait. And there is a cash flow implication. For example, you will get the loss relief in, say, suppose after 4 years, after 5 years. So for the time being, your cash flow will be not feasible, not beneficial for you. Unless if you opt for some other method, like if you opt for carry back method, then in carry back method, you can get relief in terms of tax refund. So if you'll get tax refund, then ultimately your cash flow position would be improved. So as far as the relief method is concerned, always consider the cash flow implication as well. And another issue is that what I am expecting a profit in future, is there any guarantee? If a business is in loss, it might be possible that due to severe economic issues, business might not able to get sufficient profit. So uncertainty of profit will create a problem, and it might be a thought that it is better to use other loss relief method rather than to go for carry forward. But if current year and carry back is not workable, then we have no option left other than the carry forward method. Now let's talk about some other methods of relief. So loss relief against total income. In this particular method, we have two options. We can get relief against current year total income, and we can also get relief against carry back, that is the last year total income. So in this way, we can use this relief method in either ears in isolation or in both ears in any order. What it means? It means if we have ear of loss of 1920, so we can get relief in 1920, then 1890. That means first current ear, then carry back, and we can use current carry back and then current ear. So I have created some options here. Then what are the possible options we have? We can use current ear loss relief, and then we can move to forward, not using carry back. This is an option. We can use current ear, then we can use carry back, then we can use forward. We can also use first carry back, then current ear, then forward. We can use carry back and skipping current ear, then forward, and we can only use carry forward method. So it means you can see that there are lots of flexibility, and you can use flexibility as per whatever benefits you are getting. So in exam, that might be a technical issue, that if examiner asks you that get relief or advise us about the best possible way, you will be stuck up. You have to choose every option. You have to think about every possible way through which you can save your client and you can give some better advice how to get maximum benefit of the relief. For example, if you could see that in this example, so we have tax adjusted trading profit available. So tax adjusted trading profit we have available is in year 18, profit of 10,000. In year 19, we have loss of 6,000. In year 20, we have a profit of 12,000. So we have current year loss. This is current year loss. Now we have option. We can use carry back method. We can offset against 10,000, or we can also offset against the other income of the 1920, that is 8,000. So in this way, I have the options available. I can offset the 1920 loss of 6,000 against 1920 other income of 8,000. In this way, my current year loss relief will be available. Or if I want, I can use 1920 loss against 1819 profit of 10,000. These two possible methods is available in this example. Now let's move to another example. But before using that example, let me just remind some more rules about current year relief. Then we will discuss in isolation about carry back relief. So in current year relief, we have option available to get relief, but partial offset is not allowed. We have already discussed in carry forward method that partial offsetting is not allowed. So this rule is consistent that neither we can use partial offsetting in carry forward method, nor we can use partial offsetting in current year relief method. But if we use current year relief method, then we have to offset loss with total income before personal allowances. So if we use all the income in the current year, then we will not able to get our personal allowance, and our personal allowance might be lost. So if you want to decide that you have to use current year loss relief, be careful about that, what income is available after loss relief, and can you utilize your personal allowance? If not, then you will not get the benefit of personal allowance. So it's an important consideration that you have to focus. It might be possible that if you use total income approach, then your saving NRB and dividend NRB might be vested. We also know that we have saving NRB, that is either 1,000 or that is 500, and we have dividend NRB, that is 2,000. So we have to consider this NRB as well. And if we want to use current year relief, then the date that is available is you have to claim within 1 year of the tax year of loss. The end of the tax year of loss within 1 year. So if loss year is 5th April 2020, then in that year, 20, the 31st January that you have to identify. So within 1 year of 31st January, let me just make it correct. The 31st January after the tax year. That means if my tax year end at suppose 5th April 2020, so it means I have to take 31st January following the end of the tax year of loss. So the next 31st January will be 31st January 2022. Right, that is 1 year margin after the end of the tax year ended at 2020, then you have to check the 31st January after the end of 1 year. It's not 31st January 2021. It's skipping 31st January 2021 and the next 31st January, you have to opt for this. Now let's move to an example that will create a concept in detail. For example, we have tax adjusted trading profit losses, 31st July 17, 18,000 of profit, 31st July 18, we have a loss. So the year of loss is 18-19, and then in 19, we have a profit of 10,000. We have other income each year, that is 12,000 per annum, and calculate net income each year, assuming current year relief method is used. So we have to identify income after the current year relief. So let's have a complete pro forma. Now, I'll give you the complete pro forma. So just move on to, we have in the question, we have 1718, we have 1819, and we have similarly 1920. Let me check that we have 1718, 1819, and 1920. So now, how we can utilize this? First of all, in the pro forma, write out tax adjusted trading profit or loss and see in the question that we have profit, then loss, then profit. So write out profit. In the year of loss, write down nil. And then we have profit of 10,000. So this is what the first line. Then use loss relief brought forward. It is possible that we have to use brought forward. So just write down brought forward and leave some space here. So as this is the current year of loss, so brought forward will be 1920. So here you can write zero, right? So after this, we have 18,000. Then write other source of income. And in the question, it was written as other source of income is 12,000. So we have total income available 30,000 in the last year. As we are not using carry back, so go ahead. And then we are not using brought forward in 18-19 is not possible. So we have zero, but we have other income of 12,000. So we have total income of 12,000 in the year of loss, right? So you can see that. Now, first of all, the year of loss is 18 and 19. So year of loss is 18 and 19, and I have 12,000 of income, but my loss is 43,200. Can I offset the 43,200 loss from the current year total income? Yes. So a loss relief of current year loss relief. So current year loss relief, maximum I can offset 12,000 out of the loss was 43,200. So I have opted the current year loss relief and 12,000 I can offset. The remaining loss that is available is somewhat, let me just identify. So it's, let me just calculate. 43,200 minus 12,000. So the remaining loss is 31,200. Now, as I'm not using carry back, I have the option to use carry back, but I'm not using carry back. So after utilizing this, I have remaining option of 31,200 loss relief. So I can use where I can use. So let's just move to carryback. So I have option to use carryback. So let's use the carryback method. So I have opted current year and then carryback. It means 30,000 of loss is offset. The remaining loss, now I have no option available but to use it against the carry forward method. So this becomes nil. This becomes nil. Leftover loss 1200, and I have loss relief brought forward. So I have used against the next year trading income. So 10,000. So the whole loss has been satisfied, and the remaining profit that comes out to be 8,800, and we have other income of 12,000. So in the year 1920, we have 20,800, and this is that, and we have 20,800, and this is net income. So in the year of 1718, we have no income available. In the year 1819, we have no income available, but in the year 1920, we have 20,800 before personal loans. Now see one important thing. Check that in 1819, now as we have no income, so my personal allowance is PA vested, unfortunately. And in 1718, the whole income has been utilized, my PA vested. So you have to be careful about that if you want to if you want to get the benefit of PA, then avoid using 18 and 19, because the total income is 12,000 and PA is 12,500. So you can easily offset your total income with your PA. So either use the carry back or current and skip current year, or you can also use the carry back and forward. All the options are available. You have to be careful. You have to plan in exam whatever is the method that you can use. Fine enough. So now let's talk about something, some rules about carryback method. So you have to remember that in case of carryback, again, partial offsetting is not allowed. So it's consistent with carry forward, current year, and carryback. Carryback is only for last 12 months. So there is a restriction of time period in case of carryback, that you can carry back for the last 12 month only. And carry back is against the total income always. And there is a time limit for claim. A claim must be made within 1 year of 31st January following the end of the tax year of loss. So if the tax year of loss is 1819, then check that the 31st January after 1 year. And this is same as what we discussed in current year. Same as current year. Moving forward. Now, there is a problem. There is a problem is that if you use either current year or carry back, tax authority has placed a maximum deduction rule. And that maximum deduction is called a cap. What it means, try to understand that, it's very important, that if you want to get relief from current year or carry back, there is a ceiling that you cannot go beyond that ceiling. For example, what is that ceiling? What is that restriction? The maximum deduction from total income is the greater of. First, you have to find out the greater of, that is 50,000 pounds. This is fixed, and 25% of adjusted total income. So you have to compare 50,000 and 25% of adjusted total income. Let me just put the value. For example, 50,000 and my 25% of adjusted total income becomes 40,000. Then from this figure, the greater of, I have to identify the greater of, and greater of in this example is 50,000. So what it means? It means if I want to offset something more than 50,000 in current year, that is technically not allowable, not possible, because the cap has been fixed in both current year and in the carry back. Now, how we can use ATI? Because if you want to apply cap, you just need to know the formula of ATI. So ATI, how to identify ATI? That is total income from all the source of income and deduct only gross PPC, then you will get the figure of adjusted total income, ATI. This is somewhat similar to ANI, but in case of ANI, we deduct total income, then deduct gross PPC, then deduct gross gift and donation, then we get the figure of ANI. So this is different from ANI. Remember that ANI is separate and ATI is separate. Now, let's move forward. Another important thing is that, which is always remember, that CAP is applicable both on current year and on previous year. But there is a difference that in case of previous year, CAP is only applicable on other income, not on trading income. What it means? It means that if someone is using the carry back relief method and there are trading profit as well as other income. So on trading profit, there is no restriction. You can get maximum out of it. But as far as other income is concerned, there is a restriction and you have to identify CAP for both current year as well as for the last year. Now let's see this example. It will help us to grasp the concept. So a question is that tax adjusted trading profit of 30th November, year ended 30th November, 64,000. And then subsequently for the year ended November 19, we have a loss of 1,27,800. So year of loss is 1,27,800. Now we have saving income in each year 63,000, both in November 19 and November 18. And we have gross PPC each year 5,725. Calculate the tax relief against current year 19-20 and then carry back. Although we have choice, but in this question, we have been restricted that we have to use 19-20 and then 18 and 19. So let's just use these figures and try to clear our concept that what can we can use in this particular method. So let me just put the pro forma intact, that is 18, 19 and 19 and 20. So we have trading income from the question. Let me copy it. Then in 18, 19, we have trading income of 64,000. And in this year, we have a loss. And similarly, we have saving income. Saving income, 63,000 per annum. So 63,000 and 63,000. So in this way, my total income becomes 1,27,000 and 63,000. Right? Now, I have to use loss relief. Current year first and then carry back. So let me check that how much loss is there so that I can utilize loss. The loss is 1,27,800. But before using loss relief, let me just identify the CAP of current year and then the CAP of the previous year. So let me just write loss. How much loss is there? 1,27,800 is the loss. It's loss memorandum. Let me just prepare loss memorandum side by side so that I can solve it easily. So loss is 1,27,800. Now from the question, you can see that I have the income available 63,000. But as we know that there is a cap, so first of all, I have to check the limit of the cap. Then I will use the loss, right? So the cap in current year, that is 19 and 20. Let's check the cap. So first of all, total income of 19-20. And total income of 19-20 is 63,000, 19-20. And ATI, in order to find out ATI, we have to deduct gross PPC. And gross PPC was 5,725. So if I deduct gross PPC, my ATI is 57,275. This is ATI. So now apply the cap. You can see that 25% of ATI. 25% of ATI is 14,319. Now the rule says that greater of, so we have greater of A is 50,000 and B is 25% of the ATI. So it's 25% of ATI is 14319, and we have greater of this is 50,000. So we got the permission that in current year we can offset up to 50,000, not beyond that. So I'll use that limit. 50,000 of loss is to be offset from current year, and from this loss memorandum, offset 50,000. And if we offset 50,000, then we'll get about the remaining loss that we'll use against the carryback. So now let's just go in 18 and 19. So in 18 and 19, I have to use the again the cap of 18 and 19. So let me just see the position, my remaining loss, and the position, that how much relief is further needed from the carryback. So if I deduct 1,27,800, offset 50,000, then remaining loss needed to be offset is 77,800. Now an important point, in tax year 18 and 19, I can use in 18 and 19, I have trading income, and on that trading income, there is no cap. So I can use 64,000 as it is. And similarly, I have saving income of 63,000. So up to 50,000, we have availability of up to 50,000. So that means I can easily offset the remaining portion. And after this, the remaining portion will become 13,800. But just for your knowledge, let me check the 18 and 19 cap. So 18 and 19, I have total income of 1,27,000 minus gross PPC. Although there is no need to do that, but I'm doing it for the sake of an understanding that just to check that. So my ATI for the last year is 127,000 minus 5725,121,275. So this is ATI. And now identify 25% of ATI. So 25% of ATI says that the limit is 30,318. And the greater of says that A 50,000 and B is 30,318. So I got the permission that I can use maximum 50,000. Now, from this saving income, I can use 50,000 of loss, because on against the trading income there is no restriction. So from the saving income, the availability is 50,000. So after deducting 64,000, I can get relief. The remaining available amount is only 13,800. And I have the permission to offset up to 50,000. So that means I can offset 13,800 from saving income. And in this way, I can say that first 64,000 and then 13,800. So I can offset 77,800 completely. First against trading income of 64,000 and then against the saving income. So in this way, my answer becomes 49,200 and 13,000. So that is my net income. And after that net income, the personal allowance is 12,500 and personal allowance is 12,500. We are using the tax rule of 1920, and we are assuming that 1920 rules are applicable on 1819 as well. That's why I have used personal allowances. So after personal allowances, the taxable income becomes 36700, on which I have to pay tax. And in this case, the taxable income is 500. Always remember that the choice is there. You are not bound to use carry back. You are not bound to use current year. You can directly jump to carry forward. But if losses has to be relieved as early as possible, then it is always advisable to use current year and carry back. Carry back and current year and carry back, both are same. Both will give you the benefit as early as possible. But in carry back, there is no restriction on trading income. So it is beneficial to use carry back. Similarly, if you want to use the carry back method, then in case of carry back, there is an advantage. Then in the case of carry back, you will get refund, and that will boost your cash flow position. So if you are short of cash, then it is always advisable to use carry back first, then use the current year method.